Dear civil engineers, I'm engineer Mohammed Sanor Hossein, and you are watching Civil Engineering Tips. In previous video we discussed why should we perform soil test before constructing a building. Today we will learn about the procedure of soil test, and this is standard penetration test. This test is the most commonly used in-situ test, especially for cohesionless soils which cannot be easily sampled. The test is extremely useful for determining the relative density and angle of shearing resistance of cohesionless soils. It can also determine the unconfined compressive strength of cohesive soils. This test shall be made at every change in stratum and intervals not more than 1.5 meters, whichever is less. Now let's talk about the equipment necessary for standard penetration test. A tripod stand. Standard split spoon sampler. It consists of three parts. Driving shoe, 75 mm long. Steel tube, 450 mm long. It splits longitudinally in two halves, having inner diameter as 38 mm and outer diameter as 50 mm. Coupling at the top of the tube, 150 mm long. Slip or guide pipe. It is used for hammering process. Donut hammer. It is 63.5 kilograms. Drill rod. Driving head, or anvil. It is screwed on sampler and the hammer is fallen on it to driven the sampler in the ground. Now, let's come to the procedure. The test is performed in a clean borehole of diameter 100 mm to 150 mm. At first, we are making a borehole like this. The sampler is penetrated by dynamic mechanism of hammer. The weight of hammer is 63.5 kg and height of free fall is 75 cm. The split spoon sampler is first allowed to sink by its own self weight, then blows are applied at the rate of 30 blows per minute. We have to collect number of hammer blows carefully during penetrating. We will collect the number of hammer blows in 3 stages. The number of blows of hammer required to drive first depth 150 mm is counted. Further it is driven by more 150 mm and the blows are counted. Again it is driven by more 150 mm and the blows are counted. The total number of blows required in last 300 mm penetration of sampler is given as Spt number or Spt value. The number of blows recorded for the first 150 mm is not taken into consideration. Here, we have given an example how we calculate SPT number. Let's assume for first 150 mm depth penetration we got number of blows 3. For second 150 mm depth we got 6. And for third 150 mm depth 8. The number of blows required for first 150 mm depth penetration is ignored. So SPT number will be 6 plus 8 equals 14. If the number of blows for 150 mm drive exceeds 50, it is taken as refusal and the test is discontinued. The standard penetration number is corrected for water table correction and overburden correction. In next video, we will learn how to correct M value. Thanks for watching. If you learned something from this video, then please subscribe my channel.